All this introduction what he said is useless for me to talk on Bhagavad Gita. Correct? Yes or no?
Absolutely.
And I have never learned Bhagavad Gita from any guru. It's only Swadhyaya. Swadhyaya from Nitya Chaitanya Yeti. I don't know whether you heard Nitya Chaitanya Yeti. Because Ramana Maharshi is beside me. And Yeti was an uneducated person. But he was professor of, I think, more than 26 universities on psychology. His ashram is in Ooty. If you get a chance, you can visit his ashram. He is no more. I never met him, my guru also. But his Swadhyaya book is very good. And most of his Gita learning is on psychological approach. Maybe Mahatma Gandhi is the person who introduced me to Bhagavad Gita. Because there may be only one person who wrote Bhagavad Gita as a practical book. I don't know how many of you have heard Bhagavad Gita interpretation by Mahatma Gandhi. Okay. Gita, My Mother is the title of the book, published by Bharati Vidyaman. Accidentally, I jumped onto that. Whenever we have some problem, we go and take rest on mother's lap. So when Mahatma Gandhi had a problem, he went and took his rest on Gita's lap. Maybe many people don't know Mahatma Gandhi as a real yoga practitioner. Because we know yoga is very common. And many people think that what people hear as yoga is the real yoga. But for Mahatma Gandhi, he practiced yoga, not told about yoga. The first person who took yoga around the world, or the world accepted yoga. Yesterday we were watching Mahatma Gandhi statue outside India is in 43 places.
Yeah. Many in United States.
And many places you will see. Why everywhere Gandhi is respected is because he was a practitioner of yoga. What he preaches is, Mahatma Gandhi's preaching is on what?
Ahimsa.
Non-violence. Ahimsa. That is the first step in yoga. Because Ashtanga yoga starts with Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. But today we understand yoga as only the third step, which is Yogasana. And if you know Yogasana, how to do the monkey's job of putting legs below the other leg, then we say that he is a yogi, right? And he is a yoga practitioner. Mahatma Gandhi believes that Ahimsa is the first step, and he could reach only first step. Probably he must not have practiced Yogasana in his life, because he believes in action, doing many things of his home activity, cleaning the house. Correct? All that job he does. But you don't see him in a yoga posture. So he believed that action, activity at home is more important. Why am I saying this? Because in Bhagavad Gita, you will hear a lot of words called yoga. Each chapter is a yoga. So the concept of yoga, which is explained in Bhagavad Gita, is different. And which is practiced by Mahatma Gandhi. But people misinterpret Bhagavad Gita as a book for proclaiming violence. But Mahatma Gandhi understood it perfectly and used it for the reverse purpose. Therefore, the interpretation of Bhagavad Gita has to be seen in a conflicting way. Probably I may not be able to sing or chant dhyana sloka as good as you have done or you have done. Right? But I don't know. My looking at Bhagavad Gita could be to understand what does it mean. One of the best sloka in dhyana sloka or in the whole Bhagavad Gita. I don't expect people generally, like they remember this chapter, this number of sloka is there. And this number, if you ask to chant, he will chant or she will chant. Therefore, they know Bhagavad Gita. Instead of that, I like to look at Bhagavad Gita, learning the essence. Don't think when somebody writes a poetry, every line is beautiful. When somebody is asked to draw a picture of a flower, he may draw flower, but not just flower, right? They will also draw some leaves. Correct? The stem. Stem is important or no? Or flower is important? Flower is important, but stem is required. Similarly, the whole Gita, there may be how many slokas?
750.
Yeah.
701.
It's all confusing. But how many slokas?
745 answers.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So, different versions. Right? In which, anywhere. In which, how many slokas really Lord Krishna chanted? Then only it becomes Gita. The questions are included. Confusions are included. All that is to be understood. So, what is important in Bhagavad Gita? Most of the slokas, yes or no, is a big question. Similarly, in the dhyana sloka, which is the most favorite sloka for you in dhyana sloka? The whole dhyana sloka, 9. Why?
Essence.
So what is that? Let us understand that first.
Brahma, Varuna, Rudra, it's the essence is told by everyone and even by it is
because traditionally all our faith system started with nature. Correct? The Panchabhuta concept, the elementary concept of God itself is every part of the world, not in India alone. It was everywhere. Why Brahma is important? But Lord Vishnu is a Krishna, is a Vaishnavit. Vishnu is important or Brahma is important? Or Shiva is important? She said M Brahma is what she likes and the whole story is about the Bhagavad Gita, which is of Vishnu. Contradicting?
No, they're all manifestations of Vishnu.
That's what I wanted to tell. I want to come to that. Manifestation of Vishnu because he is a Vaishnavite. But if a Shaivite will tell, it's all Shiva is much older than Vishnu. The picture also you can see. Shiva's picture is always older, right? And if you are a... Now Bhagavatam is very famous in whole India. I also must have inaugurated Bhagavatam, Saptaham in many temples in India, including Chennai and all great things happens. They call me. Chinmaya Mission also I went and inaugurated. So Bhagavatam is Krishna's life, right? But do you know the original, there is another Bhagavatam which is called Devi Bhagavatam? So what becomes famous is what is marketed. Everywhere it is true. Correct? There were a lot of conflict between the Shaivites, Vaishnavites. Brahma was not in conflict all the time. Luckily. But you can see whenever there is a Bhagavad Gita chanting also you will have Brahma's name. Because every thought process starts with the Brahma. It is not God of creation, it is God of creativity. The English interpretation by many people calling Shiva as a destroyer. It is not destroying. It is meditation. For me, Shiva is my God because I am a meditation master from Himalayas. We believe in Swami Rama, Swami Veda Bharati tradition. And I am Swami Veda Bharati's disciple. So for me, Shiva is my God. We meditate, we merge into Him. We disappear ourselves. I am not talking now. It is not me who is talking now. It is my Atma who talks to you. We reach into the Atma level, not in the Manas or the Buddhi, when we get into a meditative state. So, Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. The Samadhi stage is under the control of Shiva. So, he is the Samadhi master. But Samadhi is mistaken as death, and death is mistaken as destroy. That is where the concept came. Shiva is a destroyer. Shiva is the end of life. Shiva is the father of all the graveyards.
Actually, the correct word for in destruction in Sanskrit is samhara.
Samhara.
Samhara means to withdraw. Samharati. So it is not really a destruction.
That's what I am.
Just like a spider
which dissolving
its own web. It creates a web out of its body and then remains in it and then withdraws back in the same way.
We also get into a meditation. So samadhi is meditation. The real translation of samadhi is meditation, or meditation translation is samadhi, in which we are not existing. So if you look at Bhagavad Gita also, the essence, you will see samadhi is explained perfectly well. You do action but not expecting anything. That's ultimate. Bhagavad Gita is a book of actions, karma, but not without knowledge, not like a Shudra who don't understand things and then do. Every one of us are Shudras. When I do mathematics in my younger age, I am a Shudra. Because what somebody says, I just repeat as it is, without even thinking, why is it coming? When I am learning nursery rhyme, I am doing a Shudra's job. I don't think about what is inside. Essence is not understood. My brain is not working. So when my brain works, it becomes good. My brain works, then I realize the whole thing is not made by anybody. It is all made by Panchabhudatmakam, which, as physics principle, nothing can be created. So there is no destroy. It is only recreating. Correct? So my prana goes. It is not going. It is somewhere here. And with that, somebody else's prana is created. So when we learn about Bhagavad Gita, Dhyana Sloka, better to understand very clearly. Why Bhagavad Gita is important? When did it happen? The whole. Where it happened? Why it happened? How it happened? WWWWH. That is what learning of the context. That could be the introduction for Bhagavad Gita. Where it happened?
Madhyam Mahabharata.
No, that is in Mahabharata Madhyam.
Right.
Why Madhyam? But then
during the conflict, huh?
The whole Bhagavad Gita story comes in the center of Mahabharata, as he agrees. But Mahabharata is how many days? So when is Madhyam? 9th day is over, 10th day is what is considered. Because first day nothing happened. It's only introduction. Where it happened? Kurukshetra. Where is Kurukshetra? Still there is Kurukshetra. The place Kurukshetra is there. I went for a lecture, Kurukshetra University.
Haryana?
Yeah. You go little north, you will see Kurukshetra, and the war field is still there. It's 60 kilometer wide. The whole area is 60 kilometer by 60 kilometer. Today also the mud is little reddish. And people believe that because
bloodshed,
not only human. We had more than 153,000 elephants, more than a lakh, 1.53 lakhs of elephants, that many chariots. That is one Achavani. Similarly, seven in one side, another side also had. So it's a great war field. You imagine? 60 kilometer is not a small distance, right? You have to say in miles here. So that's a place where it happened. But Bhagavad Gita is in Mahabharata. How big is Mahabharata?
18 powers.
The greatest book in the world. The largest characters in the world. I don't know how many of you have seen Peter Brook's Mahabharata cinema. It's a beautiful movie. Then the concept of Ramananda Sagar Mahabharata will go. Because you will see Bhishma and all that, like a... We should not use few words, no? Racism will come. But the concept of God with whitish, beautiful dresses are not. That's all our imagination. Or maybe some artist must have given that imagination. So Peter Brook's Mahabharata is a beautiful cinema. It originally, I think it is 6 hours, but abridged version 3 hours is available on internet. So it will tell you where it happened and how Mahabharata is written. As our own belief. Who has written this? But he has not written.
Ganesha
is written. That's what the faith. And there are only very few stories in the world. The author himself became a character in the story. Ramayana is like that. Valmiki is also part of the story. Mahabharata is also like that, where Vyasa is part of the story. So that also is, maybe before that is Ramayana. Mahabharata is four times bigger than Mahabharata. I mean, Mahabharata is four times bigger than Ramayana. In Ramayana, characters are very less. Not too many characters are there. But here we have too many characters. And we have maybe 150,000 or 100,000 slokas.
100.
Yeah, 100,000 slokas. But number of words could be maybe 1.
Just an approximate count.
Yeah, 1.5 million. Ramayana, the problem is there are different versions of Ramayana. Mahabharata, the advantage is there is only one advantage. One.
But Valmiki Ramayana is one only.
Adhyatma Ramayana. And that's each language when it is...
Valmiki.
Yeah, that is what... But then everybody translated it, took into different... contextually different...
Language.
Not languages alone. The concept itself is different. Which is correct, nobody knows, because it's a story which has happened how many years back? No writing skill was there, no documentation, it's all no? Shruti only.
Shruti.
Heard. So when it is written, the concept have become different. There is a saying, nobody should talk about war stories. Therefore, who told whom? How did you know these stories? Telling about killing, murder is also not permitted as dharmic. So the story talks about something, then who should tell this? They created characters. That is when the bird came and the bird is telling the story. And the bird died. So if you tell bad things, you will also die. So there are different concepts. So North India, if you go, it is different. South India, it is different. The Ramayana itself, you will see, there are more than 40 versions. We had a conference in Fiji last, as part of Indian Council, I attended a Ramayana conference and then gave a talk on Ramayana. We had different versions. In Indian version is different from Lanka version. Ramayana is very famous, not in India alone. In Lanka, Sri Lanka, the Ramayana version is entirely different. Tibet, it is entirely different. The whole Kalikala started which year?
5,000 years ago.
5,000 years ago. So before that we had Dwapara Yuga. Dwapara ends when Lord Krishna disappeared. So Mahabharata happened before that. So when did Mahabharata happen? The place we learned. Now we should know where we know. When it happened? Bhagavad Gita was taught, or the discussion happened, not on the first day of the war. Bhagavad Gita is in the which parva?
Bhishma Parva.
Bhishma Parva. Bhishma Parva is 8th or 9th Parva.
9th
Parva. First day to 10th day, Bhishma was the commander-in-chief. First day to 10th day was Bhishma. Then Drona, Karma, Shalya, all that had got 1 or 2 days only. The whole war was 18 days. Last was Ashwatthama. He had only one evening. By that the war was over. So the 10th day, when the commander-in-chief was Bhishma, Kaurava is 100% sure that they will win. Because wherever Bhishma is there, nobody can beat Bhishma. They will win. So the Kaurava chief was
Duryodhana.
Duryodhana's father is the king. Who?
Dhritarashtra.
Dhritarashtra was peaceful. He never involved in war. Because his guaranteed person is there, Bhishma. But Bhishma fell on 10th day. Correct? So that is the time when the whole reason for Bhagavad Gita is this old man, blind man. He asked a question, right? Otherwise the discussion will not come. So that is why the Bhagavad Gita starts with the first line. From whom?
Dhritarashtra.
Dhritarashtra. So Bhagavad Gita is in picture only because of Dhritarashtra. So who wants Bhagavad Gita? Blind people want. Who loses sight? Who is lost in path? Who doesn't know what to do? That is the time when you have to go to Bhagavad Gita. When you don't have a Bhishma with you to support you. If you are 100% sure you are going to win your life, you don't require. But when you have fallen, when you lost the most courageous person who is supporting you, then you should ask a question. Now what to do? That time who will come? Bhagavad Vidha will come to support you. So that's the essence of. And do we have such problems in our life? We have. The most powerful people, they are all husbands. They think that I am most powerful. They are all blind people. And for such people, their wife also will become blind after marriage. Because before marriage, Gandhari was having eyesight. But after marriage, she lost eyesight. Correct or not? When husband is blind, what the wife is supposed to do?
support him with open eyes. But what Mahabharata story says? She became so lovable to her husband, so devoted to husband, she also became blind. Any wife who is totally devoted is blind. It is good for husband and wife. They will become good match and they will produce 100 children. But you will not know who is your children's company, which satsang they go, who are the friends. Therefore, even if you educate them in the best two school, like where Dharmaputra was also educated, Dharmaputra and Duryodhana educated in same professor was teaching them values. Correct? But what happened? One learned Dharma Shastra and practiced Dharma Shastra. The other fellow, he also got good marks, A plus in all subjects, assignments were 100%. He was a good student. Duryodhana never had any problem in studies. Brilliant fellow. But what happened was, not the teacher, not the family. They all belongs to same family. Dharmaputra and Duryodhana belongs to same family. Cousin brothers only. Though they were not king, but they were king's father, brother, living in same palace, same food, idli was same. Correct? But the problem was, not background, family background, not the educational background, but janma wise both are good. Parents were also good, because you cannot find anything wrong with Gandhari, or they were all very good, lovable.
No, Dhritarashtra's behavior is also like
that. But that cannot be seen as a reflection in the whole influencing Duryodhana was not. There was bad character, but I don't know whether that is influenced or not. The person who influenced Duryodhana was
Shakuni.
And Shakuni is from which place?
Gandhar
Naresh. Gandhar. Where is Gandhar?
Afghanistan.
Kandahar, Afghanistan. So Mahabharata says, don't have company with Afghanistan people. Essence of, if you have company with Afghanistan people, your children will become Duryodhana. And why this Gandhari and both mother or father? Generally, father will not control children. Who will control children?
Mother
only. Why mother is not able to control? Because she was blind. And her brother is from? Same, correct? So more than father, who influenced?
Mother
and brother. Any bad characters in this world, mostly it is mother. And if it is very good character, that's all influenced by. Every day account of 5 Pancha Pandavas have to be given to their mother. Father has no role there. You will not see role of fathers for Pandavas. Who is controlling Pandavas?
Mother only.
Mother only. Every day account. What happened? Why it happened? We do only LKG 10. Grade 1, 2, 3, 4, then they are free. But here it was not like that. Even after marriage, that's why the whole trouble. The Panjali also came because of the everyday account only. Anything which you get, you have to share.
Madhra.
So the conflict is between two. And father is not at all concerned whether there is a war happening up to 10th day. Because there is a guarantee that there is a man who will control the whole situation. Success is ours. But once Bhishma is out, 10th day. That is why Bhagavad Gita is not a live story. It's not a live telecast. It's a flashback. The whole Bhagavad Gita is in the center, 23 to 40, 18 chapters. in the Bhishma Parva in the end.
Yeah.
Different versions. If you look at something else, some other book, they will tell you here and there. Between 25 to 40. That's what it is. So it could be 23 to 40 or 25 to 42 or something. So the question was, what is the first sloka in Bhagavad Gita? So the kshetra means place. Who asked?
Sanjay.
Dhritarashtra. See, assume chief minister of a state is going out of his house. Who drives?
Chauffeur.
He will not drive, no? There is a driver. Assume there is a traffic jam. It will not happen. But still, if there is some problem,
secretary.
Immediately the chief minister will ask, or the secretary will ask the driver, what happened there? Correct? Who is more educated?
Driver.
It's natural, right? Every day what is happening to us is there in the book also. The king himself is asking the
driver.
Chariot driver about what? Dharma Kshetra. The name itself is Dharma Kshetra. That means Dharma will happen there. And we know Dharmaputra is the going to be the winner. So the person who is asking question itself is 100% sure it is a Dharma Kshetra. Dharma Kshetra, Kurukshetra. But second word is wrong. He says Dharma Kshetra is Kurukshetra. Who is Kuru?
Kuru is means do.
So it cannot be his. Dharma Kshetra, Kurukshetra. Then next line.
Samaveshai.
Then?
Mamaka.
Mamaka. Difference.
My people. And then?
Other
those Pandavas. Though the king is supposed to take care of their cousin's children, the king is supposed to take care of everybody around him. So king himself sidelines them. So the Kurukshetra is the kshetra for dharma. Therefore 100% dharma is going to win. That is why the worry starts. So this happened in on 10th day. Which is 10th day? 3167 BC, November 22nd. That's the day it happened. It's important. Very important, because Bhishma was on the nice bed in the war field given by his Shishya. Tandla, nice bed, you know, arrow bed. But he did not die. Why? Because he knows the ayanam, the Dakshinayanam, is not the nice time to die. You have to wait up to what happens that time? January 14th? Sankramanam. The Sankramanam happens. The Sankranti happens when? January 14th. So November 22nd to January 14th. How many days? More than 50 days. He was waiting. That facility is given to Bhishma. Even at the age of, he was more than 300. What was Krishna's age when Bhagavad Gita was happening? 81 years. Don't see Krishna's nice. Godrej was there that time also. He must have blacked hair. Arjuna was almost same age. Partha. The whole Bhagavad Gita, he uses only one word, Partha. Snehita. But still, there was some age difference. Krishna lived 106 years. So, the end of 106 years, Dwapara Yuga ends. Kalikala is, we must know when, where it happened, we explained. Now we are finding out when it happened. Why it happened also, we explained. correct? Because of the family problem. When it happened? 3167 plus 2018, it becomes 5000 ODS. July 18th, February 22nd, there are two arguments: Krishna's birth and death time. It happens in July, but now it is shifted to August,
September,
right? It goes from July to September. Why? Because yuga computation, by each part of the globe, there are some calculation differences. That's the reason. Ugadi is Kannadiga. How many Kannadigas are here? Ugadi. Telugu also Ugadi, no? Right? Tamil? Ugadi is there?
Chitra Vishu.
Vishu is there. Kerala also, I am from Kerala. We have Vishu. Actually, that is supposed to be the starting of the Yuga. For Tamil Nadu and Kerala, it is different. For Andhra and Maharashtra is different. That is because we follow two calendars. One is moon calendar and the sun calendar. Computation of all these will have slight difference. And slight difference is not a big difference in 5,000 years. 4 days or 5 days or 1 month is not a big difference. So, do you have to celebrate Vishu only on April 14th or from March to 14th, any day? Any day is fine. The day time has less importance. Because what we are doing, all that calendar which we have, we are transferring to Indian calendar. Indian calendar? No. Not to Yuga calendar, no. We are not talking in terms of Yuga calendar. Kali Dinam, we are not saying.
One second. The Yuga calendar is available and it is in Vedic.
It's all available. Kali Dinam.
Kali Dinam
is available.
And Puri Shankaracharya is the authority on that. And he, even today, he will give out what is the day in terms of millenniums.
That's what I'm saying. The Yuga calendar is available. Yuga calendar, Kali Dinam is available. And we know the Kali Dinam, that is the day when Krishna left, start counting the days. But we are not referring to that. What we do? Even to date Gita, what I have used is November 22nd, right? Which is the 11th month. November is the 11th month, right? Navu means 9. 9th month is called as 11th month. Okta means 8. 8th month is the 10th month. Sapt means 7. 7th month is the
9th.
Why this difference? That's because when the English calendar came, January, February comes in the first. Actually, the calendar should start from March. English calendar should start from March. Why am I saying this? Ugadi starts, happens in March or April. So original English calendar also started in March. And it was exactly matching with the Yuga calendar which we had. But then, August and Julius Caesar, they added August and his brother-in-law. Two people name were added in the calendar, shifted the whole thing to ending is February. That is why February has less number of days. All other months have 30, 31 and February has less. So which is the last month? February. Which is the first month?
March.
All Indian calendars, March is the March or April. That is the starting. Correct? And Shankaracharya was not very happy having only one calendar for whole India. He also gifted one calendar to Kerala. That will never match with any of this. Because the computation was still bad. Therefore, Kerala has got a confusion whether it is April or August, where is the year starting. Vishu is also celebrated. Onam is also celebrated as the year starting for us. So, this happened when Krishna was 85 years. November 22nd. From that, add 8 days. You will know when Mahabharata ended. Dharmakshetre Kurukshetre Samaveda Yutsavaha Mamaka Pandavascheva Kimakuruvadi Sanjaya. So he is asking Sanjaya, what is happening there? When 10th day. That means all 9 days what happened is being explained. So the first chapter explains when the war happens, how the distribution of the army, what is the formation happened. There is a beautiful book on Mahabharata war army formation. Mahabharata war army formation, written by an army man. One of the colonel was written. Beautifully. The whole thing is still applicable. Even today, army people use some of the arrowhead formation, or you can, I don't know whether you have seen the Telugu movie, famous movie, which is Bahubali. Most of the, you have seen formations. The formations were used to those time also. All the tricks were part of. And the whole first chapter, Lord Krishna is not talking, because it's a question from a blind man to his driver. Did he answer the question? When something is asked to a driver, what is his job? He has to give answer, right? What is happening there? Then immediately he should tell, this is what is happening there. But he did not answer. What Vyasa did? Vyasa added the whole story of all these days, and the hero became not Dharmaputra, not Duryodhana, but Lord Krishna. Who is the real heroes of Mahabharata? No. It's Dharmaputra and Duryodhana. They are fighting war. But when this question happened in the 10th chapter, Bhishma Parva, only little portion is given to Gita. Which is more famous now? Mahabharata is less famous, but Gita is more famous. And the whole Mahabharata people don't read, but the Krishna story is being read, Bhagavatam. Correct? The major role, major story is of Lord Krishna. So that's the beauty of Bhagavad Gita. Small problem or essence which happened. And in the whole Bhagavad Gita, every sloka is important. Description of the army. People may not like. One question is asked, answer to be given. When is it given? Immediately the answer gives, Bhagavad Gita is 2 slokas only. What's happening there? Wherever Krishna is there. Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna. But then, the description of Krishna is given as Yogeshwara. Therefore, the whole Bhagavad Gita is to emphasize and tell, Krishna is the Yogeshwara. The whole 18th chapter has only one purpose. To prove that Krishna is Yogeshwara. Which yoga? It is not Ashtanga yoga.
Karma yoga.
Karma yoga.
It is Bhagavad.
Yeah.
Prapti yoga.
Moksha. Sannyasa yoga. Bhagavad Prapti. And Moksha Sannyasam is. Moksha means happiness. Moksham is not after death. When you do work, what you derive is happiness. That happiness is your moksham. Any job which I do, if I am enjoying, then that enjoyment is
moksha.
And you are a sannyasi. Why? What is sannyasi's speciality?
Anasritaha karma phala.
Yeah.
Yona dveshtina kamshati.
Many, many descriptions are given. He doesn't do anything out of his buddhi. He doesn't do anything out of his manas. He is not doing because he wants to do. It is for somebody else.
Asanga.
Yeah.
Krishna defines in Bhagavad Gita. He says, Jnayosi nitya sannyasi yona dveshtina kamshati.
Yeah.
one who has no envy or one who has
no desire, passion. No passion.
Desire is okay, but passion is
passion not. Is not there. He is not doing because he want to do it, otherwise he will die. Not expecting anything also. That's a beauty. So moksha, sannyasa, yoga, and he becomes a Yogeshwara. Wherever Yogeshwara is there, but what is Arjuna's style?
Dhanurdhari.
But is he a Yogeshwara? No. He has got full tension. He is not doing because he want to do it. So he explained in the second chapter all the trouble which he has got. To tell that Yogeshwara is one, but Arjuna did not qualify. But wherever he gets both together, and where is our Arjuna in me or you? The desire which we have, the passion which we have to do, or the laziness which we have not to do. All that is part of us, right? So who is Arjuna here? Each one of our manas is Arjuna. And who has to join this manas? The Atma. Atma is detached. Do not involve in any activity every day what we do. But once we do, we ourselves will tell we should not have done it. We should have done it. All that who says? The Atma says. So who is Krishna? The Atma. Who is Arjuna? The manas. So when both becomes together, their success will be there. Where is our failure in life? When we have conflict between
Atma
and manas. That's why again in Bhagavad Gita, which sloka is that? Uddharet Atmanatmanam. Raise your Atma to the manas level so that you have no conflict in you. So what is Bhagavad Gita? A science of conflictology. We have a lot of problems whether to do it or not to do it. The solution can be got from Bhagavad Gita. How the conflict comes? We wanted to do so many things, but then the manas will say don't do it because XYZ reasons we will find. Same reasons in second chapter, Arjuna explains to Krishna to run away from the war field. What are the explanations? They are all my relatives. One simple question, did they become relative today? In the war field when he reached, don't he know that yesterday, before going to war field, before agreeing for a war, before committing for fighting, is that Arjuna doesn't know that all these Pandavas are going to be, have this company. He is my guru, he is my relative, who is my grandfather. So now Arjuna says, I cannot kill grandfather, otherwise I would have killed this old man. So as if we also do this. Many of our problems when we come, what do we do? Correct? I would have done all this but for, we keep lot of clauses. As if we know that close only when we are in trouble. Similarly, once answer is given to that, Arjuna will put the next argument. I don't mind killing all these people, but all these are gentlemen. If I kill all of them, what will happen to their wives? So one argument, you can see the whole Bhagavad Gita, he puts philosophical, social, emotional, intellectual reasons for not doing the job which he is meant for. He is supposed to do that, but he will find a lot of reasons. For all that, Krishna gives answer. But still, Arjuna could not decide what to do. All of us are like that. We have 100 reasons to do, 100 reasons not to do, but still we are confused, we don't know what to do. Correct? Therefore, Lord Krishna says what? Ananya.
Ananya chintayantu.
Forget about everything. What should be done? Pariyupasate. Whoever comes and surrenders to me, you forget about everything. I'll take care of you. Don't think about papa, punya, this is correct, that is correct. leave everything to God. But do we leave everything to God? Do we believe in one God? We don't. The other day, you had Arati, no? I was explaining to you the meaning of Karajarak. Kayajam, Karmajam. So many, we keep telling all this. I did so many things. I thought different things I did. If any mistake is done, who is responsible?
God,
you are responsible. That's the real meaning, right? Kayajamva, Karmajamva. If I see somewhere and something wrong, if I have seen, who is responsible? I am not supposed to see in some places, but I have seen that. And that is there in my mind when I am doing puja. Who is responsible? Bhagavan, you are responsible for that. Whenever we want to give, we all responsibility we will give. But Krishna himself knows that nobody looks and their mind is fully not with me, even when they come to my place. He knows. One of the most intelligent God in this world, who is more practical, who understands the disciple, is Lord Krishna. Therefore, he says, I know you. 100% I know. Each person who comes here also, I know you. Chaturvidha? Correct, no? Four type of people comes to me. Who are they? Who is Artho? Artho is Dukkham. Why Dukkham comes? Because you have desire. Because you are dipped in desire and you are not able to achieve it, you have Dukkham. Artho, Jitnasu. Some people will come to this place to know who else is coming. What is happening there? Correct? Where does the fund comes from? So many questions will be there in him because he is too practical. Artho Jitnasu. Artharthi. A lot of people will come to get what? Not necessarily money alone. Artham is not money. They come for famous, to become famous. Because when you come here, you can exchange your card. Some business. With that association, you get some business. Then some people will come for what? Jnanam. Last is Jnanam, knowledge. They will come and learn. So all these places, he knows these are four types of people. And who are these? Vishnu Sahasranamam. When did Vishnu Sahasranamam came? Is there any contextual relation between Vishnu Sahasranamam and Bhagavad Gita? It came on same day. No. It came after 8 days. After that. Why 8 days? Because Bhishma was bedridden on 10th day. 18th day when the war is over. 19th day, the ceremony of enthroning. He became the king. The functions were happening. But then Charvakas came and asked a question. How can you be called as Dharmaputra when whatever you have done is killing your relatives? Is it not Adharma? And you cannot be called as Dharmaputra. You have to be called as Adharmaputra. Because Charvaka is a person who can ask questions to anybody. Charvaka, today's principle is opposition group or maybe critic. Or Nirupakan.
Secularists.
Yeah, all revolutionary, all that qualification you can give.
Yeah,
Tarka. Tarka means, and he can ask questions, stopping anybody at any point of time. And understand in Mahabharata, even such a person who can ask question, the king or the god, is also given a Rishi Padavi. Charvaka Maharshi. We have not told him that he is a useless fellow, but he is a great man. That is like opposition leader gets ministerial power. They are also equivalent to minister, right? So similarly, Charvaka is given the designation of equivalent to minister. So Charvaka asks a question. Then Krishna would have given answer because he is an encyclopedia. He can give answer to anything. But he didn't give. He said, old man is lying down there. He will be there only for another 40 days, 41 days more. Go and ask him. So Charvaka goes to, no, who goes? Dharmaputra goes and asks, how should I rule this country? Dharmaputra gave an answer. Immediately he said, yes, whatever you said is correct. I have done big papa. So what am I going to do? I am going for sannyasa. So get rid of papa, leave everything and go. But the decision was told to Krishna saying that I am going tata bye bye. I don't want this kingdom. Then Krishna said, how many years you are going to do this sannyasa? One janma, not enough. Seven janmas, not enough. All that papa what you have done to? Yeah, to get rid of the papa. Krishna never said you have not done papa. This is a beautiful explanation. The whole Mahabharata justification comes because of this question. We all have this confusion. Many people have asking this question, right? When Gita is proposing war, so many papas are done. How can you say that we are dharmic people? That is why any critics who can ask any question on Mahabharata is asked by someone in Mahabharata itself. And the answer is also given there. And if you can read that 100% and understand anybody's question, any point of time, anywhere you can answer. No extra questions in this world came other than what has already been. That is why it is called Mahabharata. That's a great story. So, one question is Dharmaputra has not done dharma. Charvaka questions and then Krishna gives his answer saying, correct, 100% sure what you have done is wrong. Hey, you only told, I never told you to fight war and all that. Did I? No, you only decided. I was only a mediator. I can only tell you counseling. Like a counseling expert. I'm a psychotherapist. I do counseling. When somebody does, we are not responsible. It's your responsibility. You have done it. Did I advise? No, I told you if you do like this, this will happen. If you do like this, this will happen. It's up to you to decide. Correct? But then you want to justify? Yes. If you run away from the responsibility of being a king, you are an individual. But if you become the king, you are the king. You understood the difference? If you do it, you are killing somebody else as a king is justified. You are killing somebody as one individual Dharmaputra is wrong. A police beating somebody is justified. But the person doing is not justified. So if you become the king, it is justified. If you don't become the king, as many years you take sannyasa also, it cannot be justified. So what do you want? Be the king. But then this thought will not be creating trouble. Yes, it will create trouble. Every day you will start thinking. So what to be done? For that you can get solution. And that is knowledge. Where go to? Because he is the one expert king, no? Who?
Bhishma.
He has seen lot of kings. So, qualifying Bhishma to give this answer, the whole Mahabharata, so many stories are created. Starting from Bhishma's life. That's why Mahabharata starts with all the stories. Qualifying him to give an advice to the king. He goes and then there he says, what? 1000 names of Vishnu. What a beautiful trick. Why Lord Krishna did not answer? If Lord Krishna would have been the person who was giving answer and suspending the question, how do Vishnu Sahasranama will come? To create Vishnu Sahasranama, this trick is used. That means, who is getting marketed? Krishna is being marketed, but not by him. Don't market yourself. What should be done? Give it to somebody else. They will tell. Yeah. So therefore, and then Dharmaputra also had a question. Why should I chant this? How should I chant this? Whom should I tell this? Only to me or to whole world? 5000 years we are following this. Right? So therefore, The reason, why, when, where, how, all these are questioned. Anything which you learn from any guru, like Dharmaputra learned from Bhishma, there should be one question. Why, where, when, how, why not? Ask all questions. There are no questions. You are learning, but not at the Shudra level. Do you want to be in Shudra level? What do I get if I chant this? That means you reached Vaishya level. Okay, do I become powerful? Then you become Kshatriya level. Do I get knowledge? Then you become Brahmana level. Vedandago Brahmanaha Satchatriyo Vijayi Bhavet Vaishyodhana Samardaha Shudra Sukhamapniyat. In Dhyana Sloka of Vishnu Sahasranamam, you must be chanting this, right?
Phalasrutiya.
Yeah, Phalasrutiya. Objective and scope, that is in today's context. So the Dhyana Sloka can be either an objective or a scope, or it could be an introduction, or it could be marketing. We have all learned. I also learned my Devi Bhagavatam is what we considered as the greatest book, and we chanted. But I don't know, and I don't even know the meaning of those slokas even now, because we all learned it. Correct? But then after some time, what should be done?
Knowledge.
Charvita charvanam. Keep on repeating it, but not just like that, but understand the meaning. That is what is explained here also. Don't just put all the 1,000 names, but understand each name, what does it mean. Bhagavad Gita, end, 18th chapter also, Lord Krishna says, don't read this. Don't by heart it, but practice at least one or two slokas in your life. That's good enough. Without practicing, there is no point in learning. Then how can you practice it? Only when you understand the meaning. What do you understand? That's a real essence of the whole Upanishads. Were a lot of questions which are asked by all the students when they learned Veda. Veda is the textbook. How many Vedas?
Four.
Again confusion. Three Vedas or plus one Veda? Because the last Veda is not considered as real Veda. And what Veda says? Become desireless, be a sannyasi. So Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda. And we have got lot of groups. He is a Rig Vedi, he is a Yajur Vedi, he is a Sama Vedi. Does it mean they learn different things? They learn same. That means all the three Vedas I am only same. Content is same. What is the difference? In Rig Veda, it is all hymns, small, sentence wise. Sama Veda, it's all musical. And what is Yajur Veda? Action, karma. Yajur Vedi will do the homas. And Sama Veda will sit there and then sing. How to do and what to do. He is a marketing person. Sama Vedas will go around and then market. Rig Veda will tell you the real theory. One is practical, another one is theory, and the other one is marketing. All that has happened, and many people learn this according to their style. Everybody has same question, and questions are asked by students. And such questions are answered in your guide book. Question and answer, right? That's called a guide. And that is what is called Upanishads. And all the Upanishads you take, not one or two Upanishads. Take all the Upanishads, take the essence and then put into one book is called Bhagavad Gita. Sarva Upanishad. Sarva Upanishad, not one, not 18. Not only the Rig Veda Upanishads or Yajurveda, Sama Veda. All the Upanishads you take, Sarvopanishato Gavo. Consider that as a cow. Sarvopanishato Gavo. Then Dubdho. Who is going to milk the cow?
Krishna.
Krishna. And this is called a milking. When you milk, this is how you catch. Correct? And if you catch like this, this becomes which mudra? Nana mudra. Chin mudra. Chinmudra is Jnana Mudra. So that is why when you are milking the Upanishad cow, which mudra you are using? Jnana Mudraya
Krishnaya.
Krishna used the Jnana Mudra because the cow is not the normal cow. The Upanishad cow. The Upanishad cow is milked. And what do you get?
Bhagavad Gita.
Bhagavad Gita. So that's the beauty of Bhagavad Gita. So where did it came from? Why it came from? How it came from? When it came from? I think this much I explained. Correct? This is all what I know. Now if you have questions, ask. How much time you missed? 1 hour. Good enough? And I not jumped into Bhagavad Gita wantedly. I was only talking on few subjects around rituals, meditation, yoga. That was my field. But from Kerala, they keep calling for lectures. So when they called for lectures, some Krishna temple called me for a lecture. I said, yes, I'll come. Those days, telephone. No SMS, no WhatsApp. No mobile contact on phone. They said, I said, fine, I'll come. And they had sent me the notice. In the notice, it says my name and Bhagavad Gita. And I telephoned and told them I never spoke about Bhagavad Gita. It happened in 2005, 13 years back. I said, I never spoke on Bhagavad Gita, so I cannot speak. Right? I was in Hyderabad. I stayed in Hyderabad. This happened in Kerala, my hometown.
You still stay in Hyderabad?
Yeah, I'm still in Hyderabad.
Yeah,
I'm in Malkajgiri.
I'm in BHL.
BHL?
Ramchandrapur.
Okay. BHL, I came only for the BHL R&D for lectures.
Yeah,
personality development and such programs. So then, those days I had an article which used to come in Indian Express. I was writing about earth energy and all that in Indian Express. So somebody while was packing vegetable, he got a newspaper in which my name was there, that article. Because we generally use newspaper for that purpose. And he telephoned to Indian Express and found my address, telephone number. He came to my house. While coming, he got lot of monthly magazines which were published from Kerala. There is a Narayana Tapovana Swami who comes in. He has got maximum disciples in Kharagpur and all that. He's an North Indian expert but now settled back in. He's a Shankara disciple. So there was one magazine which he publishes from in Ashram, which has got lot of interpretations on Bhagavad Gita. And this Baburam, his name was Baburam, he was from Padmaravanagar College, Padmaravanagar in Hyderabad. He underlined the whole thing and then he has given that book to me. And he said he is a railway employee retired. When he wanted to go to Kerala, his ashram, he will travel and he is a railway employee, he has got first class pass and he can also take one assistant. So he said he will take me as his assistant while traveling so that I will be of help to him in the Kerala. He knows I am from Kerala and all that. He studied about me and all these books he gifted to me and went. He has given his address and all in the book. When after 1 month, 2 months, I started reading all this because there was one requirement of Bhagavad Gita classes, right? And I got some book where Bhagavad Gita is underlined and explained. I read all this and to give a thanksgiving, I wanted to go to him and catch his address. Telephone was not working. He himself was not identified later, not visible. His address was not there. No such person was there. So this is how I learned my Bhagavad Gita. Starting was that. Before that, I must have read because you cannot read from Gita, my mother, and give lectures on Bhagavad Gita in temple, no? So then I started my Swadhyaya. One of the best book which I found is like these books must have been
tell us a few light on Ashtavakra Gita. Tell us a few light
very difficult. Very difficult.
Hard to digest.
Very, very difficult. But I have read Uttara Gita.
Swami Sarvaprayananda has described Ashtavakra Gita very,
very, very difficult. Very difficult.
He does it.
He does it
very sweetly. Uttara Gita, how many slokas?
Uttara Gita's, what book I have got is published from Ramakrishna Math, has got nearly 80-85
slokas. 85
slokas.
He got 205 slokas.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Different people published only very little. Not available. Many of the places.
Yes.
Correct, no? Many of the places it's not available. It's not popularized well. The whole Bhagavad Gita being taught to Arjuna by Krishna, he couldn't understand anything. He said, whatever you say, I will do it. After the war, on a cup of tea, Lord Krishna was asked by Arjuna, you taught something in that four cassettes, which I forgot, I don't understand anything. Tell me now what is Bhagavad Gita.
Again I want.
Who didn't give the whole thing? Then the essence is given as Uttara Gita. So Uttara Gita is again essence of Bhagavad Gita in a crisp fashion, but not to fight war, but to live after this war.
Just to give a Indian philosophical aspect to it, what Bhagavad Gita says is Purva Paksham.
This is the Uttara Paksham.
Purva Paksham. Purva Paksham.
Samadhanam api Bhagavad Gita.
Correct.
And the Purva Paksham is look at the way things as it is. And let that explain you
all that can be said not when there is a problem. Solve your problem, then do it.
Yes. Uttarapaksha is after having considered what was my perspective, what has happened, what it may imply in future to you, to me, to different people, and perspectives today. What they do in Supreme Court, having done the case in High Court, District Court, they do it in Supreme Court. No extra evidence is given. It is rescheduled, re-researched, and a conclusion is come which can be different than that. So from Purva Paksha, when you graduate to Uttara Paksha, things becomes much more sublime. I will not say different, but it becomes much more sublime and you get lost into it.
And Krishna says don't read anything. Don't read Veda at all. Ananda Shastram Bahu Vedidavyam Alpaschakale Bahu Vaschavignam. The whole life you have got a lot of problems. Why are you wasting time reading all this? Go and rule the country. That's good enough.
Another thing is, Vasishta is also same. Bodhita
Gita. Yoga Vasishta.
Yoga
Vasishta. That's actually a psychological book. I keep saying Yoga Vasishta is the motivational lecture. Make anybody active. Yoga Vasishta is the best book.
Atma
Kata.
To know who you are.
Yeah, who you are. Then it's all inside you. Krishna is inside you, Arjuna is inside you. Brahma is inside you. Hridaya guhara madhye kevalam Brahma matram. Inside the Hridaya, if you look at it, there is only Brahma. The creator is inside you. You start thinking. And that thought process is more important to realize yourself. That's what is the realization. Because ultimate aim is realization. Correct. Yeah, the interpretation of Shankara on Gita is one of the best. You should gradually reach, probably, Yadi psychological. I have got a friend of mine who writes continuously for last 10 years. I am seeing that he writes biological interpretation to Bhagavad Gita. You can search biological interpretation to Bhagavad Gita. And he is from Kanyangad, Nityananda Ashram. He is the editor of one magazine, Nanagita. Beautifully every month one article comes from him, biological interpretation. So it's only Bhagavad Gita is only one question, one answer. The question is asked, but answer is given in the 18th chapter. Correct? Yatra Yogeshwara. That's the answer. That's again Sanjaya. Question is asked by Dhritarashtra. Answer is given in the 18th chapter by Sanjaya. So if you read first, that's how I think Bhagavad Gita should be read. Read the first chapter, one question. Identify where the answer is. Read that. Objective is given, scope is given, question is asked, answer is given, the conclusion is given. Like when you write a thesis, you write synopsis. This is your problem. Problem is suggested, then the solution, conclusion. How can you conclude this? Then read in between. So I keep saying that's one of the best method to write a book or write an article. Don't, people are in eager to know. If you really read it, you will be eager to know. Where is the answer? No? Then the answer will come. 66th sloka or 68th sloka, I think. Then the rest of the slokas are only who should do it, why you should read, why you should not read, who are qualified to read, who are supposed to practice, supposed to preach, supposed to give lecture, only when you practice it. But which is the center of the sloka? అనన్యశ్చింతయంతో మాం యోజన పర్యుపాసతే తేషాం నిత్యాభియుక్తానాం యోగక్షేమం మహామయం. ఇన్సూరెన్స్ కంపెనీ ఎల్ఐసి ఎంబ్లమ్ యోగక్షేమం. ఐ గ్యారంటీ యు యోగా. యోగా ఈజ్ యు వాంట్ బుద్ధి. వాట్ ఎవర్ వీ లెర్న్ షుడ్ నాట్ బి ఫర్గాటన్. వాట్ ఎవర్ పవర్ అండ్ పొజిషన్ వీ గోట్ షుడ్ నాట్ గో. వాట్ ఎవర్ మనీ వీ గోట్ వీ keep it safe. I guarantee you all the three. Only one condition. What?
Insure.
Eh?
Insure.
I insure you. I will give you. But don't default any of the
premium.
Every and what is the premium with God? Not once in a month, once in a day, only Thursday.
Every time.
When? Mamekam Sharanam Raja, surrender to me. Because he knows many people will come once in a week only. Thursday only. That too morning only. Or he says no. And when? Okay, forget about all that. You don't do also, I'll guarantee you. Andha kalecha manase smara. Correct no? Andha kalecha. What is andha kalecha? What is your andha kalam?
Last.
But he didn't say, there is a cha added there. Not last, andakale cha. The last moment also you think about it.
Andakale cha, andakale.
It is not andakale, it is andakale
cha.
What is important?
Yeah. After retirement.
No, no. Not after retirement, at the time of death. But how do you know when are you going to die?
Philosophy is that.
Therefore, because you don't know when are you going to die, what should be done?
Do it now.
Every time. Always. Because so anytime you can be Krishna Rama Govinda.
That is the philosophy.
So I think this is the real marketing technology. He says, don't use it only at the time you want. Correct?
We meet again next
good week. Enough? No questions?
I don't know. Has anyone got any questions?
I mean, very nice.
Only two people have no questions. Should I say it?
Yeah.
Somebody should not take it anymore.
Who understood, who don't understand.
Yeah.
No, but there is another one.
Either fools or the sublime.
No, that is one. The another one is it's time for lunch.
So we have...
another category is there.
So, we are starting. All time we are there. Good being
met. You must be knowing
that. I don't know Sanskrit. My wife knows Sanskrit and all the time I was carrying her on a scooter. So I know Sanskrit not from the front, from the back.
So you read the scriptures in English?
I read in Hindi.
Hindi and English.
Devanagari. I read. Because we all learn. Eh? I read the Sanskrit.
That is my main agony now. I also
see, what I did was, all that. I have got a book called Nitya Sloka, probably of your interest.
Okay.
That all my books are available on the internet. This is a Nitya Sloka book, which I created in Hyderabad, Malkajgiri. I used to have lot of children. Saturday satsang. What I do is, I used to teach all the slokas.
Sanskritam na jana.
Little. That's it. I can't speak.
Think you should learn Sanskrit.
Yeah. I know, but it
is very of the so many other languages. But
I thought it's anyway Deva Bhasha, I will speak to him after my birth. And I work along with the Sanskrita Bharati propagating and all that.
Yeah, Sanskrit
doing very good. Gulf country, they are very active,
and
so I keep going to Gulf
country. Also, they are doing very good.
And Malayalam has a lot of Sanskrit words.
Yeah, yeah, it's very simple. To learn is not a big problem.
My request is, I am from Sanskrit Bharati.
Right. He was telling that somebody is active. So I could guess.
I am requesting that. Yeah, if you want, then Dasadena Sanskrita Bhasha is Namna Sivram Prachalati Sarabhara.
10 days you can learn Sanskrit from
Sanskrit Sikshana Avasakam to Dhatum Aam Siddhavas.
I think we should start. That is more.
We did the introduction.
We read all these things. We read, we are trying to understand. But we are calm when we do all these things. When it comes to the time when we have an issue, none of these things come to the...
See, Lord Krishna also answers this question. He says, Sthitaprajna is very difficult. Sthitaprajnasya ka bhasha. How can a Sthitaprajna should speak? Tell me that so that I will speak. How many people you think I have a Sthitaprajna? Fine? Lord Krishna says it's very difficult. But practice it, you will get it. How do you practice? 18 days practice. Fine? But the problem is the people we are dealing with are not so sthitaprajna. So we have to fluctuate. Nothing wrong in fluctuating. But soon after that, are you able to control? Then it's nothing wrong in getting angry. But soon after that, are you able to control? Or you keep on adding compartment to the engine and make it too much heavy, then difficult.
What's your good name, sir?
I am Dr. TPS. You can search me Dr. TPS on there. My WhatsApp number is active.
WhatsApp number is active? Yeah, I see it's taken.
I've got some for people who interact with me.
How long you are here?
I don't know. Maybe here or not.
Many scriptures, so other than Sanskrit language, is also equally good. That's
essence is more important.
Worry or pain agony.
Essence is. That's what this Nitya Sloka I wrote in English scripture so that everybody can read. And each sloka which I can give an explanation. That's also available on that. Yeah, my blogs are Nitya Sloka blog. 64 blogs are there. One of the slogans is Nitya Sloka. So you get all the slokas.
So very nice. It was nice.
Oh. That is, she made the website.
We meet again next Saturday at 10:30.
So this will happen every Saturday?
Yeah.
For another 2 months?
Yes. I mean, unless he's traveling.
No, we have good speakers. You must get them. He should speak. That is one best thing. Then it becomes discussion. Yeah, more. I love to learn than teach.